Hey guys, it's Mathew here once again, and I do need to give you guys a bit of an update on the old Frostblades Molten Strike Raider slash Pathfinder sort of character, because at this point it is basically a choose your own adventure, play whatever the hell you want, plus Molten Strike sort of character, and also a few different little ways of building it as well, because I'm currently using Fizz Claws, even though I recommended to initially go elemental damage weapons. That was based off of a pure Spectral Throw and Molten Strike build, whereas this can now be a Wild Strike, a Frost Blades, a Lightning Strike, a Spectral Throw, and a Molten Strike build, and because of those reasons, you can very easily use physical weapons, and what I'm using is two Wasp's Nests, because they are a very good start to this sort of character with the kind of damage they give, the crit, the attack speed. And you can see, you can even use Molten Strike as a pure clear speed skill if you really like, as demoed here. I just personally didn't really like it too much because you do have to wait for the balls to drop a little, and that's not terribly comfortable when you do have the alternative of slapping on a different four link of a different skill and enjoying it a lot more, I'd say. So I have, however, been trying out every other skill as possible. I did use Spectral Throw for a bit, but since my weapons are physical, I don't have a full LE conversion happening, and Spectral Throw did feel a little lackluster for those purposes. As well as that, it's not really linked up in this case, it's just a 4 link, and on the 4 link it's a little lackluster, so you do need a 5th link coming from a Shaper item or a Thunder Fist to really do it any justice. So then I also tried out Wild Strike and compared it quite rigorously to old Frost Blades, and they seem really comparable. Frost Blades probably has a slight edge against lesser pack size monsters on the clear speed. It's a bit more ranged and it has a bit more of a intuitive chaining capability, for example. Whereas Wild Strike, it's probably a bit more fun because it's just madness, and as well as that, you do get quite a lot of area happening, so you can clear real packs real easily. Ultimately though, it is just your Molten Strike that's going to be doing all of the work for the single target, and then you pick whatever damn skill you really like as your alternative clear to Molten Strike. But like I said, you can even do Molten Strike if you like. A lot of people have found success with Lightning Strike they've been enjoying. Basically, Ancestral Call makes all kinds of skills just feel really nice to use for clear in supplement to your Molten Strike. So Frost Blades, Lightning Strike, Wild Strike, Molten Strike itself, just Ancestral Call basically attached to anything feels great in this conversion physical to elemental sort of build. Now, besides all of that though, there are quite a few other little tidbits you can change here, although there, thanks to new Shaper items, new Elder items, some new uniques, as well as that Lycosidae is a lot more expensive, so it is still the best option for the build to just use one hand weapon and Lycosidae, but it's something like 150 chaos, and that is pretty ridiculous when two Wasp's Nests averaging 1 to 4 chaos is doing just as good. And you can see we really haven't had any problems. I've been running my two Wasp's Nests, which, yeah, like I said, just a couple of chaos each, have taken me through all the maps up to tier 14 that I've run so far, as well as the Guardians, or Elder Guardians rather, and Elder himself. Damage has been great, the clear speed is totally fine, it's just up to what other gear you have to accommodate the current Wasp's Nest you are using, or if you have some nice Ellie Claws, that's totally fine too. It still really doesn't matter, but it's just Wasp's Nests are a totally nice baseline weapon for some life gain on hit, some claw action, good cast speed, good crit, or good attack speed rather, good crit, and then a good bit of damage. So overall, it's been going pretty damn well. I have, for the most part now, stuck to playing Wild Strike plus Molten Strike, been farming, trying to get my way through more Shaper stuff towards the actual Shaper himself, but the Atlas is pretty huge at the moment, so I'm not sure if I'll even get this character all the way through to Shaper stuff, but you can reference the previous version of the Pathfinder, who has easily gone through all of that content and was one of my favorite boss killers I have played to date, because Molten Strike is just so goddamn nice. And I will go over exactly how I've set my character up in just a second, but I do want to give you just a small teaser of what the Elder Guardians and Elder look like on a moderate tier. They're like tier 7 to 10 here, so they're nothing too special, but you can see that we are well capable of completely face rolling, face tanking, and life gain on hitting our way to victory with the vast amount of balls we drop. As always, we do have our trusty noob text over to the side, cataloging most of what I use. I am currently using a belly as it suggests, which is a 5-link. Got that from the Belly Prophecy by buying it for about 70 chaos and then 5-linking it. Really strong chest for the build because we do quite need a bit of life to fill out throughout the build. However, you can easily drop some life, some damage and get more life because at this point, you know, if I just had another 500 life, I could quite easily face tank everything out there with just Molten Strike and life gain on hit combo. It's really quite strong and basically replaces Vile Pact one for one from the previous league. Haven't even taken Vile Pact yet, though you certainly could do that for extra leech. I just haven't felt the need yet, so I'm not quite sure if it's going to be necessary, but I may try it out. You can see that I have listed the tooltip damages over here, though take those with a grain of salt, they basically mean nothing. Just a reference point for how you're going, I guess, because Molten Strike here is 36 and Wild Strike here is 35. However, projectile damage on the Molten Strike doesn't increase your tooltip. So, you know, these prog nodes over here that I recently respec'd for some other stuff, they don't actually increase your tooltip at all because this is your actual melee tooltip, and thus you're not really gaining a true understanding of what your Molten Strike is doing. And likewise, Wild Strike, this is the damage before the conversion happens to all of your physical into elemental and then gets scaled by elemental, so really that means nothing either. And the reason I am now Wild Strike is just because I wanted to try it out instead of Frostblades and go a slightly different route with my tree so I could actually accommodate something like Wild Strike more. So I got rid of a lot of my prog nodes, and right now I am very much open to interpretation for what I can use as my skill. It doesn't have to be both projectile based, because I've only really got these as projectile nodes anymore and just point blank. Otherwise, it's very generic. We have this over here, which converts our physical to cold. So I'm 100% elemental with our Molten Strike, since that's 60% conversion. Wild Strike then gets fully converted over here. So that's physical to elemental completely as well. Overall, I'm not really dealing any physical, and that's what you get if you grab some wasp's nests or some other physical weapons. If you don't, you don't really have to grab these, but they are still good damage regardless for the ice bite or added cold, which I'm not currently using anyway. And of course, this is a bit different to my previous tree because I have to grab claw nodes, and I didn't really think I needed as much life this time around, at least not yet. So feel free to have a look at this tree and play around with it yourself, as well as that Twin Terrors, since I am dual wielding instead of actually using a Lycosidae. So somewhat importantly, there is a bunch of stuff you can do with the new stuff out there of Abyssal items, Shaper, Elder items and all that. And you can see here I have a pair of gloves with a built-in level 18 faster attacks. So that's the best I've got for a fifth link on my Wild Strike, which currently has Wild Strike, Elemental Damage, Ancestral Call and Multi-Strike. So no real beefed up added cold or ice bite, unfortunately, but that is still just fine and makes it so I attack really quickly. And then over here for my Molten Strike, I'm running Molten Strike, Ice Bite, Elemental Damage Attacks, Multi-Strike, Ancestral Call, and my sixth link is probably Conk Effect, maybe damage on full life, but Conk Effect seems like the best choice at that point. I doubt I'll be getting that far, however. And then I do happen to have one of these nifty rings. It's a Shaper ring that has Curse Enemies with level 8 Assassin's Mark on hit. Now, the difference between a level 8 Assassin's Mark and a level 19 or so over here isn't really very big. We're talking 1% additional crit, and that's about it. That's literally all you get out of an extra 11 levels. So you're not really losing anything by wearing this thing, but you are gaining 35% mana. So I've been running Hatred plus Herald of Ice for the most part. Now, it's not a big deal if you don't have a ring like this, because they are pretty rare at this point, because not running Hatred and then having a Blasphemy and a Herald of Ash is still really good and really close in damage comparatively. And Blasphemy, of course, makes it a little bit stronger. So yeah, it really was barely worth the upgrade, but since I could get one of these rings, I decided to, and it has been going pretty well. I do still recommend you can get one of these rings, that you should. And just on a bit of a side note, there is also another really cool mod on these sorts of rings, and that is Warlord's Mark on hit, Warlord's Mark Curse on hit. So that's really good for the Templars and Yeah, the Inquisitors and all that sort of shit. So look into those if you're playing one of those characters as a bit of a pro tip. Besides that, there's nothing actually too insane going on. Just a bit of wed, a bit of, let's cull this off, bit of wed, bit of a flat damage across the board wherever you can get it. Found this amulet that's really nice for crit multi and elemental damage. And also bought a 2 Molten Strike projectile helm for about 50 chaos a few days ago. And this is the type of helm enchant you are looking for primarily for damage. It's going to be definitely additional projectiles to Molten Strike is going to be your biggest one. So try and get some of that if you can, but they are fairly expensive. So just flat damage, maybe some ice golem enchant, whatever else you can get is still going to be just fine. And as well as that, I did find this belt, which was really nice. So you try and get some elemental damage to attacks on your belt. Try and get some just all kinds of different damage onto your jewels over here. But it is really tough to balance your Wise Oak to get more than just one or even two resists at this early stage without having the option to Mastercraft and Scour and all of that, level 7 masters. So currently I only have capped on 95 and 95 for cold and lightning. So my fire isn't getting the 15% penetration. And that is a pretty big loss, especially for Molten Strike, which converts half my damage to fire. So I'm going to have to try and do something about that. I barely deal any lightning damage, so getting that capped isn't really helping me too much. So in my current setup with lots of cold and fire, I definitely want to try and cap cold and fire the most. If you're running something like Thunder Fists, or have a lot of lightning damage elsewhere, then getting lightning capped is going to be pretty good for you because that will help your penetration towards mostly lightning damage. So I'd say mostly that is pretty much all the important stuff and the few little tidbits out there taken care of for you guys. Don't take any, stock of what's in my helm. I'm just leveling shit over here. I do have pretty much an entire spare four link, so that's something I might play around with. But for the most part, yeah, physical weapons, elemental weapons. In the absolute end game, what the best one will be is probably a really good elemental weapon because getting a really good physical weapon is going to be much harder. So these are just a nice baseline. You'd need something like 300, 350 elemental DPS on a claw to compete with this at this stage. And they are realistic to get, but definitely a bit harder, I think. So this is a really nice starting stage if you're going to go the conversion route with things like Molten Strike, Frost Blades, all of that. And I do recommend you guys just play around with whatever skill you like. So Wild Strike, Frost Blade, Lightning Strike, and come across your own best setup because what I like may not be what you like, but ultimately we are all Molten Strike fanboys and then something else in between. So I will, of course, drop you guys the character profile as well as that, the path of building. It's Yeah, kind of tough to really look into what this means. We have about 100,000 damage per ball. However, that is with Ancestral Call over here. So it's vastly lower than what the previous character had because he never used Ancestral Call. But this should, in theory, under perfect situations, give you twice as many balls or, 66% more balls, something like that, while cutting your damage by a bit. So it should be worth it, but bear in mind that the way I'm using Ancestral Call with Molten Strike isn't going to be super effective against monsters that constantly want to attack you and constantly hug you. It only works if you have a nice little gap between whatever you're attacking and yourself. So if you can stand back, shift click, you'll then have your two extra Ancestral Protectors or Ancestral Calls attacking as well, thus combined having three separate Molten Strikes going at the target at once. You want to forget all that. It's probably not that bad of an idea to just get rid of Ancestral Call. Chuck in Conquer Effect, for example. Then you can face tank a lot easier and just sit on top of the monster without having to worry about nerfing your damage. So play around with that. If you can get it going like I have on some bosses, it definitely feels good. By no means necessary, though. For now, though, I think that's probably all I'll say about the character. I may have Guardian and Elder and maybe even Shaper stuff, just clips coming up in the next few days, but I may start another character on a whim. We'll see how we go. For now, though, guys, this character has been very enjoyable for me. I hope you guys are having some sort of success or that this video helps. Thank you very much for watching and see you next time.